Man, it was stunning sitting there, literally watching a map that was blue and red just become increasingly red, not just in the South, but the Midwest, the middle of this country.
When you went into this election, in this White House and the Democratic Party, they were looking for raising the numbers, boosting the numbers of black people going to the polls. Now, the places where there would have been more of a challenge and a difference were supposed to be in the areas where there were high populations of black people. But in the Midwest, how many places have high concentrations of black people? Okay.
Right, but,
so therefore, but okay.
But it was the Northeast.
Well,
it was the Midwest.
Right.
It was the South.
And
Democrats. But the reality is, Republicans, they really took this with the white vote.
Yeah. Yeah.
African Americans voted for Democrats. 60% of Latinos voted Democrat. It was really white voters, independents, senior citizens who simply said, you know what? We know what happened 2 years ago. We're moving over to the GOP side.
Well, as I said, when the Scott Brown thing happened, you ignore the Tea Party at your peril.
That's right.
And I think this idea of going out and basically saying the Tea Party, they're a bunch of loons, blah, 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 blah. Okay, you can say what you want. But at the end of the day, this was the group that was actively mobilized. This was the group that was ready to go. And this enthusiasm gap that they talked about, it was real.
You use the key word, Karen, mobilize.
Yeah.
Do you believe that coming out of having that coalition, that they pretty much just allowed it to fade away, and that they did not understand the mobilization part until it was too late?
Well, certainly, I think if you look at the numbers, the Obama surge voters, that coalition of voters, were not as mobilized or as well mobilized this time as they were in 2008. I'm sure there are a lot of reasons for that. I think they were hoping that having the president get out there sort of in the last weeks would help boost that, as April was talking about. And interestingly enough, in Illinois and Pennsylvania, in the places where our Democratic candidates did very well, those are the places where Barack Obama did go and spend quite a bit of time. But I do think that the GOP did a better job mobilizing their people, and to their credit, although they were initially nervous about the Tea Party, they realized, you know what, we got to get on board with the Tea Partiers and get them out.
They kind of ripped
them up. The leadership wasn't, you know, Mitch McConnell, I mean, a lot of these guys initially, they were, you know, not sure how they wanted to deal with the Tea Party.
That's what grassroots does. Grassroots will drive them at the top.
But look, 29 million people who voted in 08 did not vote this time around. 29 million people. Number two, you don't walk onto a college campus 2 weeks before an election and say, go vote. You got to have absentee ballots. These kids were away from home. That stuff has to be planned. Number three, he forgot to use, or they forgot to use, the social medium that young people use. You had two problems. Young people didn't vote in large numbers, and African Americans didn't really vote in key places. And then finally, if I can add this, they came after us, Roland. Those of us who have radio shows and talk shows at the last minute.
The president did at least 16 black radio programs from September the 10th.
You can't do that at the last
minute.
And I hope, you're going to do the other panel on Where Do You Go.
Right.
But the lesson is, you got to be doing that all the time.
And I'll tell you, actually, the Latino vote is one of the places that is the most dramatic example of that, because initially the Latino vote was on track to not be quite as high. But then there was a reaction to that horrible ad that Sharon Angle ran, and that's when people actually said, oh, no, and got engaged, not because they were proactively outreached.